Hello friends, my name is Vivek Sharma. Today we can cover this interesting problem that's called minimum path sum. So in this problem we have been given a MIN grid filled with non-negative numbers and we need to find a path from top left to bottom right which minimizes the sum of all numbers along its path, right? And node section is you can only move either down or right at any point in time. Alright, so this is the matrix, okay, and we can only move right or down. I just copied this diagram to whiteboard here. So let's try to see couple of paths here. So if we see the paths here, one path is basically, or let me choose the different color here, maybe the red color. So one path might be this. So this would be like 1 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, right? So what is the sum here? 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 1, 7. Right? 1, 3, 4, plus 1, 5, plus 1, 6, and plus 1, 7. So this is one path. Right? Another path, so we are just going right side. So this is right. And this is down. Right? So we can either move down or right. That is the constraint given in the problem itself. Alright, so let's follow this path now. So first down and right. So first down is 1 plus 1 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. So what is the sum here? 1 plus 1, 2 plus 4, 6 plus 2, 8 plus 1, 9. Right? So 9 is greater than 7. So till yet 7 is the eligible, like it is the candidate minimum sum. Right? Let's figure it out other path as well. So we can go down and then we can turn right from here. We can go down from here and we can turn right. This is also one path, right? So let's try to calculate this sum as well. 1 plus 1 plus 5 plus 2 plus 1. So what is the sum here? 1 plus 1, 2, 7. 1 plus 1, 2 plus 5, 7 plus 2, 9 and plus 1, 10. And there would be other path as well, right? So this is also one combination. But again, 10 is greater than 7. So till yet 7 is the candidate sum. Other path might be like 1, 3, and then we can just turn down from 3 itself. And then we can again turn right, and then we can again go down, right? So this also 1 plus 3 plus 1 plus 3 is 4 plus 5, 9, and that is also exceeding 1 and 1 again, it will be 11. So there might be multiple paths. Our target is to find out the minimum path sum, right? Once we find the minimum path sum, we need to return that. So this is another clean white page on the whiteboard. So we can start it from here as well. So basically, we need to either go down. All right, so this is the constraint. Now this is the problem. Now how we would solve this problem, right? So at any given point of the time, basically let's collect the observations here. So one observation is for the direction. We can either go down and right. So this is the right direction and this is down direction, right? So D is for down here, just for simplicity. Alright, so this is one observation. Another observation is for the minimum path sum, right? So we need to find the minimum path sum. So minimum path, right? We need to find the minimum path sum. So this is another fact or observation here. Not the observation, but we are just collecting the facts from the problem statement itself. Alright, so direction is clear. Once we will go right side, what we can do, we can just take the right, we can just move forward through to the right side and we can just check the previous and we can just keep accumulating, right? So when I say the keep accumulating, we can just keep accumulating from the left side, right? Once we will move for the rights to the right side. Also, if we will move to the downside, we can just keep accumulating from the above side, right, to the downside. So that's what we can do. What about the diagonal elements, right? So diagonal elements, we cannot move to the diagonal elements. That's correct. We can just either move either right side or downside. But for the diagonal, we can come either from downside or right side. So we cannot directly go like this direction, but we can reach to 5 either from 3 or from 1, right? So what we need to do, even for the diagonal element, we need to find from where it would be minimum to come to the diagonal point. Once we know what is the minimum path or minimum sum that is coming from which direction, then we can take the minimum and then we can calculate, right? So let's move to here and let's see what I mean to say. So to the next page, and let's consider this example only, right? So let's say if we are moving to the right side and downside. So for the right side, let's say if we follow the same approach, right? So initial the element would be 1, and if we are moving to the right side, then this is 3 here, right? So what we can do, 3 plus 1 4. Why 4? Because we cannot do, we have to accumulate, right? Once we are moving to the right side, we have to accumulate from the left, right? Similarly, 1 plus 4 for this one as well, we have to do accumulate to the left, from the left, right? All right, so this is, we covered the right side. Now let's cover to the downside. So for the downside covering, we will see the next one here, and next 1 plus 1 is 2. So what we are doing, we are just adding this one, right? And then 2 plus 4 is 6, so we are now at 4, and we are trying to accumulate whatever the top sum, right? Whatever the sum here in this cell. So this element is 1, but we accumulated here 2, right? That's why we are adding this 2 plus 4 is 6. All right, so we covered right side, right? R is right, and downside is D for down. Now what about the diagonal, right? So diagonal, basically, let's see this cell, right? So this cell, this is not 0, by the way, this is just a cell, right? So this is, let's this cell, so this cell will be either it will consider 2 or it will consider 4. So which will be the more eligible candidate to reach here, right? Definitely the minimum, because we are calculating the minimum pass sum. So whoever is the minimum from either 2 or 4, we will just consider that particular cell, and we will accumulate to this cell as well, right? So this cell is basically 5 here, this is 5, right? And then we will check what is minimum between 2 and 4, right? So 2 is minimum, we will accumulate here, 5 plus 2 is 7, all right? Similarly, this guy is also diagonal. Diagonal means this can be either, it can come from 7 or it can come from 6, right? That's why I am saying diagonal, even if it is the last row, but it has the two options, right? So we will definitely go with the minimum option, that is 6 out of 6 and 7. So 6 is minimum, then we will add here 6 plus 2 is 8. All right, so this guy is also diagonal. Diagonal means it also has two options, right? Either it can come from 5 or 7. So we will consider 5. 5 plus 1 is 6. Again, this guy, right? So this is 1. And then we will again, it can come from either 6 or it can come either from 8. So which one is more appropriate? More appropriate is 6, right? So we will add here 6. So 1 plus 6 is 7. And in the end, basically, so our target is, we will start from top left and we have to reach to the bottom right. That's what the problem is saying, right? So we have to find a path from top left to the bottom right, which minimizes the sum of all the numbers along its path. So the 7 would be our answer. Now let's walk through other example as well, right? So this is the problem that we have been given. We can make our on matrix, right? Just to understand, just to clear our concept. So let's say I am having this matrix here. I'm just making some random numbers here just to play through, right? So remember, we cannot take the negative numbers, so it should be non-negative numbers, right? So I am just taking the non-negative numbers here, right? So 1, now let's say 2, and then let's say this is also 1. So let's see what will be the minimum path sum here. We can just considering, we can just go either right or we can just go to down. All right, so let's consider this path. So it is 1 3 4 5 and 7 and 8. So this is one path, okay? And what about this path? So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 6 and 1, 7. So 7 is, I think, eligible. I mean, it is lesser than 8. So we can just consider this path is it is a 7. Now let's consider other path as well. So if we follow this path, right, what is the sum here? 1, 3, 4, 5, 7 and 8. So this is also 8. So it looks like this is the minimum path sum, right? So 3, 4 and 2, 6 and 1, 7, right? Let's go through other paths. So if we will consider this path as well, right? This is not minimum because 4, 5 and 5 plus 2, 7 and 8, 1, 8. And if we will consider other path as well, then also they are not basically they are not minimum, right? So for example, this particular path 1, 3, 4, 5, 2, 7 and 1, 8, right? So definitely this path is looks like this is minimum until we find more minimum, right? So let's see 3, 4, 2, 6. So this is also one path basically, but this is also having the sum as 7. All right, so let's follow the same idea, right? So if I choose a different color, maybe blue color. So the first element would still be 1. 1 plus 3 is 4, right? Because now we are moving to the right and we have to move to the downside, right? So whenever we will moving to the right, we will have to accumulate from the left side. And similarly, 1 plus 4 is 5. Now we are moving to the downside. So if we will be moving to the downside, we have to accumulate from the top side, right? So 2 plus 1 is 3. 1 plus 2, so 1 plus 3 is 4. Remember that we have to accumulate whatever the sum it's coming, we have to keep accumulating because we need to find the sum, right? So don't add these guys, right? These guys will be added initially, then whatever the accumulation is there, that we have to keep adding, right? So whenever there is no path from top and left side, then we will fill like from the previous element, right? But wherever we have the option that it can come either from the top side or left side, then we will consider whoever is the minimum eligible minimum, right? So let's say for example this particular cell, right? So this particular cell would have the choice, right? And so which is minimum, like 3 and 4, right? So 3 is minimum. So what we can do, we can just add 3 to the 1. So we can mention here is 4, right? So we can mention here is 4. Now let's consider this guy, right? So 5 and 4, which is minimum? 4, of course. So we can just add 4. So 2 plus 4 is 6 here. Now which is minimum? 4 and 4, it does not matter, they both are same. So we can add 4 plus 2, so it is 6 now, right? And which is minimum? 6 and 6 here for this particular cell, right? So for this particular cell, basically they both are same, so we can add 1, we can add 6 to 1 and then it would be 7. So basically this would be our reply, right? This would be our answer. So I think conceptually, if we are clear, we can quickly convert this approach to the code itself. But first of all, we need to clear like what is the concept, what are the observations and how we can convert this thought into the code. So let's do this. Let's try to create a couple of placeholders and then we can go from there. So the base condition would be definitely if grade itself is null, right? Or let's say grade dot length, if it goes to 0, then definitely the minimum path would be 0 because there is no non-negative numbers, right? So minimum it can go till 0, not less than that, because there is no negative, right? So I is less than and let's say m is grade dot length, n is grade 0 dot length, and I plus plus for, oops, there is typo here, so integer j equals to 0, j is less than n, and then j plus plus, right? So now let's cover all these conditions, right? So what we need to do, if let's say if we are moving to the right side, right? So if we are moving to the right side, then what we need to do, we need to keep accumulating from the previous, right? So for the right side, what condition we need to check? That this row is zero and column is not equals to zero, right? So if we see here, the row is zero but column is not equals to zero. So this column is not equals to zero, column is one but row it's still is zero. So that's the same condition we need to write here. So let's say if I equals to zero and j is greater than zero, this is one condition. Similarly for downside, right? So for the downside also, j equals to zero but I should not be zero, right? So for this cell, we have to accumulate from the top, from the above of this cell, right? So similarly, what we will do, else if j equals to zero and I is greater than zero, right? Because this is the basically we are just covering the first column, right? So the row should be greater than zero, and here we are covering the all the columns. So row should be zero but column should be greater than zero, so that we can accumulate from the previous, right? So we can accumulate from the previous. Let's say for this cell, right, we are accumulating this cell basically from left, and we are accumulating this cell from the top. So that's what we need to make sure. Now for the diagonal, right? So for the diagonal, if our I is greater than 0 and j is greater than 0, means we are somewhere in the middle, right? So it means somewhere we are here in the middle side, right? So either we are here or we are here in the middle, right? So if we are in the middle, then we will see that what is the minimum option, right? Whichever sum is the minimum, that we will consider to add, to accumulate. So let's go ahead and do that. So how we will do this, grid I j, right, plus equals to, now let's take from the left side. So we will do I minus 1 and j. So so this is I j minus 1, right? And similarly here, grid I j. Now let's take from the above from this cell, right? So this would be basically I minus 1 and then j. Alright, so now if it is diagonal, then let's fill whatever the minimum is there. So let's go ahead and do this. So math dot minimum, and math dot minimum is grid. So minimum means either, so for example, if we are filling this cell, we need to check either this is minimum or this is minimum, right? So we will go do the same thing. So either grid I j minus 1 or grid I minus 1 j, whoever is the minimum, we will just accumulate, and in the end we will just go ahead and return the last element in the grid, m minus 1, n minus 1, and we should be done basically, right? Complexity wise, basically time complexity and space complexity, it should be m into n, because we are traversing basically two dimensional row and column, so it will be m into n. Space complexity, if we take any other auxiliary array, then it would be again m into n, but we are not really taking, we are just updating the same matrix, so it should be order of 1, right? Now let's so this idea is clear. Let's quickly check for the compilation error and let's correct those if there is any. If there is not any, let's quickly try to submit and let's see if it is working as expected. So looks like this idea is working, and then we should be good in terms of our proof of concept, right? So even before ending this, like let's walk through our observations. So there are a couple of facts that we collected from this problem. Is the direction wise, we need to go here in the note section, we can only move either down or right at any point in the time, right? So we can either move right and down, and that will give us the sense like how we should solve this problem, right? Because we know, now we know the direction. And then another observations here is basically this minimum path sum, right? So we need to get the minimum, whatever the minimum is possible, and that will give us basically whenever we are moving to the right side, right? And if it is the first row, then we are keep accumulating from the left side. When we are going downside, then we keep accumulating from the above side, right? So, and then this will fill basically these cells. So for example, if I fill this cell, and then in my loop, if I reach to this cell, right, then this cell will have either two options. Either it can come from this side, from the top side, or it can come from the left side, right, considering that we have only two direction. So if it is having two choice, this particular cell, then we have to choose the minimum one out of these two, and that's why we are taking the minimum of these two. Whatever the minimum is there, then we are accumulating to this particular cell, and that's what we are getting it here. And similarly, the same approach basically we are applying to get the result, and in the end basically we are accumulating in the end here. So this is basically our output, desired output that we are looking for. So hopefully this is useful. Thanks a lot for your time. Have a good one. Bye.